going to join, maybe, right? So let me share my screen. Okay. Right. So we are going to discuss about the versions of the SQL Server. Okay. So version is nothing but an updated software copy of the SQL Server. Right. So we have different versions in the SQL Server. Okay. We have like SQL Server started its journey in the early 80s only. Okay. Finally, it came into the market with the SQL Server 95 edition. Sorry, version with SQL Server 95. Okay. In the year of 95. See here, if I mention number here, that means it was introduced in that year, okay? 1995, 1997. If you see here SQL Server 2000 means this SQL Server software has been introduced in the year of 2000, okay? So usually SQL Server version means you can see SQL Server with the year, okay? In which year it was introduced, usually mostly it will be introduced in the same year, more or less, okay? Maybe 2000 means 1999 or else 2001, like that it may be introduced, okay? So we have different versions in the SQL Server, okay? We have SQL, usually 95, 97 and all we haven't used, not that much famous, okay? But from SQL Server 2000 onwards, it was very famous. Still organizations are using SQL Server 2000, still organizations are using, means almost all 20 years over, okay? Almost all 20 years over, but still organizations are using 2000. You can ask why they are still using the old version. It is not going to support any features and all, new features and all not there, but still people are using 2000. Why? Because maybe their project is not getting any revenue. They just want to maintain their application. So if they want to upgrade again, they have to pay the license fees and all. They have to pay license fees for Windows. They have to pay license fees for SQL Server as well. So simply the projects which are not getting revenue or much revenue and all, usually they are going to continue on lower versions and all. But Microsoft is not going to support SQL Server 2000, 2005, 2008, 8 or 2012 as well. Okay, 2012 also Microsoft is not going to support. Support means if any issues come, say for example, you bought one laptop, there will be one warranty, 2 years, 3 years warranty kind of thing. If anything happened to that laptop in this warranty period, it will be replaced freely. Okay, after that also they are going to provide support. Okay, if something issue with your laptop and all, they are going to provide support with a cost. They are going to charge the money and they are going to provide the support. That is called support. Okay, so Microsoft, we are buying product from the Microsoft. The SQL Server is a product from the Microsoft. Okay, so we are buying product from the Microsoft. So it will only support any software, any version, it will support up to 5 to 10 years, mostly 5 to 10 years. With all extension supports and all, it will support mostly 5 to 10 years. Sometimes if you go for individual support and all, it may be increased, but it will not support 20 years and all. Okay, so nothing will happen. If it is not going to support, nothing will happen. You can run the software easily, but if any issues comes and all, you have to troubleshoot it, you have to fix it. Otherwise, Microsoft is not going to help you to fix those issues and all. Okay, and it is not going to release any updates also. So if any risky kind of, like say for example, any virus kind of thing is there. Okay, so if any attacks are there on the system, Microsoft is not going to release any updates for that. So always the older versions will be in risky state. Okay, so we have different versions in the SQL Server. SQL Server 2000, if I go with the SQL Server 2000, SQL Server 2000, SQL Server 2005, then in the year of 2008, it was introduced one more version. In the immediate year 2008, it was introduced second version called R2. R2 means release 2. Okay, R2 means, I'll tell you what is the 7.0, 8.0, 9.0. Don't worry, okay. Later, after 4 years, it was introduced to SQL Server 2012. Then after 2 years, 2014, then 2016, then 2017, then 2019. The recent version is SQL Server 2019. Okay, the latest version is SQL Server 2019, which was introduced, okay, in the year of 2019. Means, of course, it's not latest, almost all 1.5 year over, okay? Right, so the SQL Server 2019 has been introduced in the year of 2019 and all, right? So if you see here, okay, you can see there are different numbers, 7.0, 8.0, 9.0. What is these numbers? Anyone having any idea? What is these numbers? Okay, so I'll tell you that numbers are called build numbers. Build numbers. Okay, if I want to say what are those numbers, build numbers, BUILD, build numbers and all. Okay, I'll tell you what is this build number, where we are going to use this build number and all. Okay, right. Up to SQL Server 2017. Okay. Up to SQL Server 2017, or else if I want to say up to SQL Server 2016, SQL servers are platform dependent. Remember one thing, SQL Server is an application. If you want to install this application, you should have one operating system. Okay, if you want to install this application, you should have one operating system. Operating system means what? Simply your Windows 10 or else Windows 7, Windows 8, 8.1, these are all the operating systems. Okay, so if you want to install SQL Server up to SQL Server 2016, it will only support the Windows operating system. Means you cannot install the SQL Server software in any other operating system. We have different operating systems, right? We have Windows operating system, we have Linux operating system, okay, and we have iOS from Apple. Okay, we have different operating systems, but SQL Server up to SQL Server 2016, it will only support for Windows operating systems only. Okay, we have different types of Windows operating system. There are actually two types of Windows operating system. Okay, one is desktop OS, and the second one is server OS. OS means operating system. Okay, if I want to say what are the different versions of desktop operating system, can anyone tell me what are the different versions of desktop operating systems?
Windows XP, Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10.
Very good. So what and all we have discussed now, Windows XP, 7, Windows Vista, Premium, okay, Windows Basics, Windows 8, 8.1, Windows 10, which you are using in your laptop, those are all Windows desktop operating systems. Okay, so we have different operating systems as well. Those are called as server operating system. We have other operating systems also from Microsoft only. This Windows also introduced from Microsoft only. This OS, Windows operating system, has been introduced from Microsoft only. So your operating system is also from Microsoft and your SQL Server is also from Microsoft. Both are same vendors. Okay, so here, if you want to install your SQL Server, either it can be installed on Windows desktop operating system like Windows 8, 8.1, Windows 10, or else it can be installed on server operating system. So what is the major difference between desktop operating system and server operating system? Why don't we use desktop operating system in the organization? Why? Because there are a lot of limitations with your desktop operating systems. There are a lot of limitations with your desktop operating system. Okay, so mainly if I want to say limitations in terms of resources. Okay, the RAM is small for desktop operating system. It is not going to support 16 GB, 32 GB. Mostly it will support now latest laptops and all, maybe it is going to support 32 GB. Okay, or else max to max, it will support up to 64 GB only. But imagine in the organization, 64 GB RAM is just a piece of RAM, just a peanut of RAM. You can see servers with 256 GB RAM. So you can see servers with 512 GB RAM. 512 GB, not storage. There is a difference between RAM and storage, memory and storage. Memory means you're like what we can say, random access memory, okay, which will help you to process the data and all. ROM or storage, read-only memory, which is going to use to store the data. Okay, by using your storage, okay, if you see, if I just open my computer, these are all storage, okay, 250 GB, 1 TB, 2 TB, like that you can have machines. Like some people will buy external hard disk, right, 4 TB, 5 TB, like that external hard disk and all. That is storage. But RAM, if you see the RAM, you will have used mostly for our laptops, people, common laptops and all, homemade, people, we are using some laptops, right? The personal laptops and all PCs, that laptops or desktops will have 4 GB RAM, 8 GB RAM, 12 GB RAM, mostly 16 GB RAM, okay? And else like 32 GB RAM like that. So can anyone tell me where I can see my RAM information? It's easy question only, I know, okay? Where I can see my RAM, in how many ways we can see the RAM information?
System information.
Very good. And another thing? Okay, so we can see RAM in different ways. One is task manager. If you go to task manager and if you see the performance tab, okay, there you can see, okay, your CPU and memory. Okay, this is one way. This is old operating system, Windows 7. Okay, you can see here total RAM is 12,151 MB, means 12 GB RAM. This machine is having 12 GB RAM. Or else if you want to see in another way, just open Windows R, run. Open Windows run, okay, just type MS Info 32. This is the shortcut, or else you can type system information also. You can simply type system information also in the Windows like this. You can see here, right? System information also. The shortcut is MS Info 32. Once you just open the shortcut, you can see here the installed physical RAM is 12 GB. Okay, the installed physical RAM is 12 GB, means my laptop is having a 12 GB of RAM and 1 TB of storage. Okay, so mostly common PCs and all will be having same limitations. So the problem with the desktop operating system is there is a limitations in terms of resources. You cannot use more RAM, you cannot use more storage and all, but that is an advantage of the server operating systems. Okay, so Microsoft has been introduced different operating systems for this SQL Server purpose and all. So those operating systems are called as a server operating system. You will have, okay, this server operating system will have a lot of capacity. Okay, you can insert 512 GB of RAM also. It depends upon your requirement. I'm not saying every server in the organization is having 512 GB of RAM, but max you can go for 512 GB of RAM. You can go more than beyond 512 GB RAM as well. But depends upon your requirement. Some servers will have 32 GB, some servers will have 16 GB, 8 GB, like that. But the capacity, the max capacity is, okay, very huge when compared to desktop operating systems. And usually personal computers, you are going to, whenever you have work, you are going to work with it and you are going to shut down it. But servers you cannot shut down the servers, okay? Those servers has to be up and running for 24/7/365 days, means like our heart, how our heart is working. In the same way, servers also should run, okay? Continuously they should be up and running. So they should have more capacity when compared to the desktop operating system. That's why in the organizations, we are not going to install SQL Server in desktop operating systems. We are going to use server operating systems. Like how we are having different versions of the desktop operating system, Windows 7, 8, 8.1, 10. Okay, in the same way, we have server operating systems also, Windows server operating systems also. There are different versions of Windows server operating systems. Okay, these are the Windows server versions. Windows NT 3.0, Windows NT 4.0, Windows Server 2000. Same, we have SQL Server 2000. Don't confuse. We have SQL Server 2000 and we have Windows Server 2000. We don't have SQL Server 2003, but we have Windows Server 2003. We have SQL Server 2005, okay, but Windows Server doesn't have Windows Server 2005. Then again, after 5 years, after Windows Server 2003, after 5 years, Windows Server 2008 has been introduced. Then in the same year, R2 means release 2 has been introduced. Okay, then after that, after Windows Server 2008 R2, we have Windows Server 2012. Then again, we have Windows Server 2012 R2 as well. Then we have Windows Server 2016. Windows Server 2019 is also came into the market. Windows Server 2019 is also came into the market. Right, so these are the different versions of the SQL Server as well as different versions of the Windows Server, right? As I told you, you can install SQL Server, okay, earlier up to SQL Server 2016, okay, up to SQL Server 2016, SQL Servers are platform dependent, means you can only install the SQL Servers on Windows operating system when till SQL Server 2016. From 2017 onwards, SQL Servers are platform independent, means you can install SQL Server 2017 on Windows operating system, as well as you can install SQL Server 2017 on Linux operating system also. Okay, you can install your SQL Server 2017 on Windows and Linux. So up to SQL Server 2016, it is a platform dependent, means only on Windows operating system you can install. From SQL Server 2017 onwards, you can either use Windows operating system or you can use Linux operating system also. Because of competition, they have introduced that particular SQL Server on Linux operating system as well. But Linux operating system is not that much famous. People, I don't see in the companies they are using Linux operating system for SQL Server. Okay, so people still using Windows Server only for their SQL Server needs and all. Right? Any doubts till now? Any issues? Any issues? Any doubts? Fine. Can I continue? Just let me know if you're having any issues. Right. Okay. Silence is no. Fine. So, right, we have discussed this thing. Right. We'll discuss one important point now. Okay. So now we'll have one question. Can I install all of my SQL Server versions on all of my Windows servers? Yes, no, maybe. Can I install all of my SQL servers on all of my Windows servers? Is it possible to install? If yes, okay. If no, why we can't install? Can I install? Can anyone tell me the answer for that? So the answer is simply no. You cannot install all your SQL Server versions on all your Windows servers. Okay. That is called compatibility issue. If I want to say what is meant by compatibility, the small example, the better example is in your childhood, you are going to wear some clothes. Can you wear the same clothes now? You cannot. Why? Because in the childhood, your height is different. Okay. Your measurements are different. Everything is different in your childhood. But if you want to wear the same clothes now, it's not at all possible. Okay. So that is called compatibility. Okay. The SQL Server 2000 has been introduced in the era of 2000. So every SQL needs an operating system, right? So what they will think in the era of 2000, they will not imagine, okay, in the era of 2019, Windows Server 2019 operating system will come so that this SQL Server 2000 is compatible with the Windows Server 2019. They will not think like that. They will think simply whatever existing operating systems are there by the time in the era of 2000, they are going to manage, they are going to plan their things as per the existing operating systems. Okay, so you cannot install all your SQL servers on all your Windows servers. If I want to say the very lower version of SQL Server, you cannot install on very higher version of Windows Server. Okay, the very lower version of SQL Server, you cannot install on very higher version of the SQL Windows Server. In the same way, okay, the very higher version of the SQL Server, the very higher version of the SQL Server, you cannot install on very lower version of the SQL Server. Okay, the very higher version of the SQL Server, you cannot install on very lower version of the Windows Server. Don't confuse SQL Server, Windows Server. Don't confuse. SQL Server is an application. Windows Server is an operating system. Okay, SQL Server is an application. Windows Server is an operating system. Don't confuse at all. Means simply Windows Server 2016 has been introduced in the year of 2016. But SQL Server 2000 is introduced in the year of 2000. How much gap is there? Almost all 16 years gap is there. So in the year of 2000, that developers who developed the SQL Server 2000, they will not imagine, okay, in the year of 2016, Windows will introduce Windows Server 2016. So it has to be installed on Windows Server 2016. They will not think like that. They will think as per their existing resources and all. Then how to easily, okay, remember on what Windows servers I can install what kind of SQL servers and all, right? You will have the same question, right? There is a basic formula for that. Don't worry at all. Okay, for every SQL Server version, it will support -7 years to +7 years. Every SQL Server version will support -7 years to +7 years. Okay, so if I go with SQL Server 2012, this is not a bookmark or like something like that. This is just to remember easily. That's it. Okay. There is no rule like this. I'm saying there is no such kind of rule, but to just easily remember, I am just giving this hint. Okay. If you go for SQL Server 2012, on what and all Windows operating system I can install the SQL Server 2012? You are working as a SQL DB. Some customer came to you. Hey, so and so. Okay. Can you please install SQL Server 2012 on Windows Server 2000? He asked like that. What will be your answer? Okay, I can install. No issues for that. Don't say like that. You have to check the compatibility first. Can you install SQL Server 2012 on Windows Server 2000? Okay. So if yes, how? If no, why? Okay. So every SQL Server supports -7 years to +7 means before 7 years and after 7 years, whatever operating systems are there, you can install the SQL Server, okay, on those operating system. Apply the same concept here. What is the -7 value of 2012? What is the -7 value of 2012? 1998. Okay. And what is the +7 value of 2012? Sorry, 1995, right? 2005. Okay, the -7 value of 2012 is 2005. And what is the +7 value of 2012? 2019. Okay, so in this range, whatever operating systems are there, 2005 to 2019, whatever Windows operating system are there, you can install your SQL Server 2012 on all those Windows operating system. Go here. Okay, just check whatever Windows Server operating system are there. So here. Okay, so what are the Windows Server operating systems are there in this range? 2005 to 2019, 2008 is there, and 8R2 is there. Okay, and 2012 is there, and 2016 is there, right? So that's it. 2019 is also there. Okay, so you can install your SQL Server 2012 on all this Windows operating system. Damn sure you can install. For other operating systems also you can install, but you have to go for a patchings and all. Okay, you have to like apply some service packs and all, then only it will support for more or less one or two versions of Windows servers. But damn sure you can install your SQL Server 2012 on all this Windows operating systems. The benchmark is -7 years to +7 years for the SQL Server version. So if I want to ask on what are all the Windows servers I can install my SQL Server 2005, can anyone tell me SQL Server 2005 on what and all Windows servers? People will ask. Sometimes you will get a requirement to install old versions also. Okay, so don't, like, if people are already having some knowledge on the SQL Server, don't think why I'm discussing about the 2005 and all, but sometimes you will get the requirement. Remember one thing, we always discuss about the worst cases to best cases. As a DBA, we should know the worst cases and best cases as well. Okay, right? So that's why sometimes we'll get a requirement also. Sometimes we'll get a requirement. Can you please install me? Why? Because that application will be compatible with only some kind of limited database versions only. So that's why sometimes people are going to ask to install old versions of the SQL Server. Right, if I ask you on what and all Windows servers I can install my SQL Server, what will be your answer? Can anyone tell me? Anyone try, just at least try for that. SQL Server 2005.
Windows Server 2000.
Okay. So just let me know the range first. Okay. What is the range?
Range.
Just like we have range here, right? Yeah. Like that. 2012. This is the range. Okay. So
2000 to 2012.
2005 -7 years. Okay, how much it is? 1998. 2005 +7 years, it will be 2012. So whatever Windows Server operating systems are there in this range, whatever operating systems are there, what and all operating systems are there, Windows Server 2000 we have, okay, and Windows Server 2003 we have, and Windows Server 2008 we have, and 8R2 we have, and 2012 we have. So on all this Windows Server operating system, you can install your SQL Server 2005. Is it clear? Fine. I'll ask one by one again. If you have any issues, very important thing. Amani, is it fine with you?
It is.
Okay, Anil. Anil, is it fine?
Fine.
Yeah, Ashwin.
Fine. Yeah, fine, sir.
Yeah, Banu. Banu Pratap.
Fine, sir.
Lavanya.
Fine, sir.
Madhavi.
Fine, sir.
Okay, Ramesh.
Hello, fine.
Yeah, 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 okay. Fine, Ritesh.
Fine, sir.
Yeah, Rajesh. And Shyam.
Yeah, fine, sir.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, if you have any issues, just let me know. Immediately, I'll explain, okay? Right, fine. Okay, so these are all the Windows Server operating systems, and we have already discussed about the SQL Server versions as well. Okay, those are the Windows versions, Windows Server operating systems, and those are the SQL Server versions as well. What is this 7.0? What is this 8.0? First, let me connect to any of one SQL Server now. Okay, I'm going to use Management Studio to connect. Okay, how to get the Management Studio, how to install the Management Studio, everything I'm going to discuss. Don't worry at all. Okay. Usually Management Studio is a tool. There is a separate discussion on the management tool, Management Studio tool. Okay, I'm going to take one class on Management Studio. Okay, this Management Studio is an application or a client which is used to connect to the server. Remember one thing, in the organization or else any application will have client server model. So to connect to my database, I am going to use the Management Studio. Management Studio is simply a tool to connect to the databases. Okay, so Management Studio is a tool to connect to the databases, whatever databases are there, SQL Server databases and all. How to get this Management Studio? Whenever you install SQL Server up to SQL Server 2016, okay, you will automatically inbuilt, you will get the Management Studio. Whenever you are installing SQL Server inbuilt, you are going to get this Management Studio. From 2017 onwards, Microsoft introduced Management Studio separate tool. You have to download it and you have to install it separately. Okay, fine. So let me connect to any of the server. Okay, let me connect to any of the server. I don't know whether this is running or not. Yeah, it's running fine. I'll tell you what is this connect button and all, why we can see here database engine and all. Okay, I'll tell you again, don't worry about it. I'll tell you, I will explain each and every option here. Don't worry about it. So I just want to show you something. Okay, one number called build number here. Okay, if you see here, there is one number called build number 11.0.5058. By just looking, you cannot easily identify the version of the SQL Server. Every SQL Server belongs to one version. Maybe belongs to 2005, 2008, 8R2, 12, anything. It may belongs to any other versions, right? So how to identify the version of the SQL Server? If I ask you this question, how you are going to identify which version it belongs to? Which version the SQL Server belongs to? Or else we have another SQL Server as well. Okay, let me connect to that. Okay, which version the SQL Server belongs to? There are two instances. Instance or server, both are same. As a DBA, we are going to call it as a instance, SQL Server instance. Okay, people will call servers and all, but we are going to call as a instance. Instance means one SQL Server software is called one instance. This is one SQL Server and this is one SQL Server. Total, I have two instances in my local machine, right? So here you can see one number and here also you can see one number. Okay, by these numbers are called build numbers. This is your server name. After that, you can see one number. Then you can see login, with which login we have created to this SQL Server. This is login name. Forget about it. Just concentrate on this number. So how to identify the version of the SQL Server? Here you cannot say which version it belongs to. You cannot say by just looking the name. Sometimes they will clearly mention the name of the version in the instance name, but usually in this case you don't see any version, right? But which version it belongs to? If I ask which version this instance belongs to, what is your answer? Can anyone tell me?
2008 R2.
Very good, excellent. 2008 R2. How he said 2008 R2? Nowhere it was mentioned as a 2008 R2. But by using this build number, you can see it belongs to 2008 R2 version. And this was belongs to 2012 version. How to say that? Go to this notepad. Here you can see 2000. Okay, just concentrate on the first two digits. Forget about the third number. Actually, build number contains four parts: major version, minor version, actual build number, revision history. There are four parts will be there in the build number. You can see only three parts here, but whenever you run one query, you can see the complete build number. But forget about the third part and fourth part. Just concentrate on first part and second part. Okay, 11.0, 10.50. Okay, so if you see here, if you install SQL Server 2000, your build number is going to start with 8.0. Forget about this 80. Again, I'll tell you. If you install your SQL Server 2005, your build number is going to start with 9.0. If you install 2000, your build number is going to start with 10.0. If you install 2008 R2, your build number is going to start with 10.50. 2012, 11.0, 2014, 12.0, 2016, 13.0, 2017, 14.0, and 2019, 15.0. So if you see 11.0 or if you see 9.0, it belongs to 2005. If you see 10.0, 2008. If you see 11.0, 2012. If you see 10.50, 2008 R2. If you see 12.0, 2014, 13.0, 2016, 14.0, 2017, 15.0, 2019. This should be on your tip of your tongue. Very important, very, very important. Okay, so you have to remember these values. Nothing is there. Simply start with 9.0. You have to increase one value. That's it. Only 2008 R2, it will be somewhat different. 10.50. Remaining everything 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Nothing to worry. Just you can easily remember. If you just remember 2000, people are very less versions are there. You can remember 8.0 as well. Just go with 8.0 with 2000. Just increase one by one number. Just one number to each one. Okay. So tomorrow's assignment is I will ask, the build numbers of each version randomly. I will not ask sequential order. You can easily remember. What is the build number of 2012? What is the build number of 2019? What is the build number of 2005? Okay, very important thing, very basic thing. Okay, so I'll forward this document after the class and all. Not now, okay, I'll tell you maybe in the next week I'm going to forward this document. Okay, so these are the different build numbers. By using the build number is going to help you to identify the version of the SQL Server. Okay, actual build number, how to see the actual build number? I'm just writing one query by just clicking on this, but again, don't worry, I'll tell you what is this and all, why I'm writing this query. To find the exact build number, there is one query called select at version. If you just run this query, okay, you will get this output. This is the output, okay? And you can see Microsoft SQL Server 2012, 11.0.5058.0. This is the complete build number, okay? But you can see only three parts here. In the instance name, you can only see three parts. Okay, you cannot see the fourth part and all, right? Fine, so what is this 70? 7.0, 70, just remove the dot here. 8.0, 80, 9.0, 90. So can anyone tell me what is this number? 70, 80, 90, 100, 110. Can anyone tell me that number? What is that number? Where I can see that number? What is the use of that number? Okay, so fine. Okay, so these are the folders are going to be created if you install the SQL Server. 80 folder is going to be created in your C program files. If you install 2005, 90 folder is going to be created. If you install 2008, 100 folder is going to be created. Again, if you install 2008 R2, same 100 folder is going to be created. If you install 2012, 110. If you install 14, 2014, 120, 130, 140, 150. Do you want to see those folders? Go to C. Program files, Microsoft SQL Server, okay? And yours, you can see, right, 80, 90, 100, 110, 140, 150, what will be there here? simply SQL Server supported files will be there here. SQL Server supported files will be there here. In this folders, you will have your SQL Server supported files and all. Okay, so for tomorrow's class, strictly I'll ask, tomorrow means the next weekend Saturday class, I'll ask the bill numbers, okay? So it's not compulsory, but I'll not ask like compulsory, but again, it is always helpful, the very basic information. You should know these values, you should know these compatibility levels. By using this compatibility level, you are able to identify the version of the SQL Server. Right, fine, clear, any issues, any doubts till now? Okay, right, fine. Right, so we'll go with the another concept called CTP, RCM, RTM and RC. Okay, what is this CTP, RC, RTP? I'll give you the best example, okay? Do you know what is this dry run, corona dry run? What is this corona dry run? Or what is the sample tests? If government of India want to introduce any program, first it will test the program, okay? It will choose some 5 to 10 districts in the whole country and it will just go for a test run, the pilot project. We can say the pilot project or test run, whatever we can say, okay? In the technical language or IT language, beta version. What is this beta version and all? Imagine if SQL Server, if Microsoft want to release SQL Server 2021 or SQL Server 2022, it will not immediately release 2022 and all. It will start working before 3-4 years. Okay, before 3-4 years or 5 years and all, what kind of features we are going to introduce. It has to imagine the future and all. Okay, so it will start working in the, maybe in the year of 2019 or 2020, like that it will start working and it will release by 2022. But it will not suddenly release the whole version. Say for example, WhatsApp, I'll give you the best example, WhatsApp. For some of the people, there are different features in the WhatsApp. The meeting is going to close now. Can anyone see it is showing less than 1 minute? Shyam? If you see, yeah. Less than 1 minute, yes. If I don't close it,